Give me fuel, give me fire, give me that which I desire.
Hey everybody, and welcome to part one of the METALLICAST'S in Summer for All series. I am your host and fellow Metallica fan. My name is Brandon. Now, first and foremost, let me explain to you what the In Summer for All series is. In case you missed the last episode where I introduced and explained it, or you're not following me on social media, which by the way, you should be. I'm at METALLICAST'SPOD on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. But in case you are out of the loop, let me explain to you what this series is all about. During the summer, starting with this episode, I'm going to be releasing a weekly track-by-track breakdown of the Injustice for All album, with each week taking a look at a single track. I'm going in chronological order, starting with track one this episode, that of course being Blackened. Next week will be the title track, Injustice for All, so on and so forth, ending of course with the final track on the album, Dyer's Eve. During that episode, I will also be filling in any of the blanks that I missed along the way in terms of the writing process, recording process, its critical reception, its influence, etc. Now, I need your help, METALLICAST'S Militia. I want to make In Summer for All as interactive as you are willing to make it. So let me explain. If you want to contribute an album review of Injustice for All, or a review of a single track off the album, send it my way via social media. Email me, metallicast@fansonexperts.com. Or maybe you want to contribute a cover song of one of the tracks. Or maybe you know of an awesome cover song of one of the tracks that you want to share with me. Or maybe you want to guest host an episode with me. I'm going to be looking for guest hosts, listeners included. I reached out to some of the podcast brothers, not sure if they will have the time, not sure if they're at all interested in contributing to the In Summer for All series, but I did reach out to Metallica podcasts and non-Metallica podcasts. We'll see who gets back to me, but maybe you, the METALLICAST'S Militia, could help me out in that way as well. Do you want to finally have a crossover between METALLICAST'S and another Metallica podcast? Let them know on social media, and hopefully we can schedule something, get it in the books, and make it happen for you. Do you have any other suggestions for the Summer for All series? Then please let me know. Do you want live episodes? I'm willing to give that a shot via Facebook Live or another outlet. Or maybe you have thought of something awesome that I have not yet thought of that I can use to make this the best experience possible for you and the METALLICAST'S Militia. Just let me know. Again, hit me up on social media. Again, I'm at METALLICAST'SPOD on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Or you can always email me, metallicast@fansnotexperts.com. Now, without further ado, let's start with the first episode of the In Summer for All series, where I look at track one off the Injustice for All album, Color World Blackened. Injustice for All is the fourth studio album by Metallica. It was released by Electric Records on August 25th, 1988, which means this summer in 2018, it will be the 30th anniversary of the album, which is part of the reason, and also because of suggestions from some of you in the METALLICAST'S Militia, that I have decided to do the In Summer for All series to celebrate the 30th anniversary of this album. Now, as I already said in the final episode, after I break down Dyer's Eve, I'm going to be going into a lot more of the writing process, recording process, critical reception, etc., etc. But obviously, in order to do this track-by-track breakdown correctly, I'm going to have to address some of that as we go along. one important thing to know, which I think a lot of you probably already know, but this is the first studio album to feature Jason Newsted on bass, of course, not including the Garage Days Re-Revisited EP. This was the first album after Cliff Burton died in 1986. So there is a lot of unknowns for Metallica fans and for the band themselves going to the recording of this album. But Blackened is an interesting song in the sense that it is one of only a few writing credits that Jason Newsted received while in Metallica. Now, I found this article from Guitar World magazine, and the question is asked, you co-wrote Blackened off of Injustice for All, which I think is one of the greatest album openers of all time. What do you remember about how that song came together? Newsted replied, yeah, the main riff is mine. I wrote it on bass, though. I've never told this story before, and it warms me a bit. I'd only been in the band for a very short time. I was still in a little one-bedroom rented apartment, and James would come over to the house like we were buddies. He'd come over for dinner. We'd hang out and play guitars on the couch. It was pretty fucking dreamy for me. Metallica was my favorite band. It was pretty surreal. I had a little four-track Tascam set up in the bedroom. So we went in there and he's got a guitar and I've got a bass. I'm fucking around with this riff. And then he started playing along and the song started forming right at that time. I'm sitting up in my chair like, holy shit, dude. This is something. That was the first thing we ever constructed together. And him going, dude, that riff's good enough to open our fucking album, really gave me a feeling of victory because I looked up to him greatly and still do to this day. I also have a book that is several years old that I've had for a long time called Metallica in Their Own Words. It is by Mark Putterford, but it is basically a compilation of quotes and interview excerpts from the band members through the Black Album era. And there is an Injustice for All section, and I want to read a quote from Lars Ulrich from September 1988, where he talks about Blackened. He says, this song is a bit different from all our other opening tracks in that we've purposely avoided the whole overlong, half-hour, huge intro bullshit thing which we've done for a couple of albums now, and everyone else seems to be doing it as well. So this song comes out blasting well. So this song comes out blasting at you from the word go. Musically, it's also a bit different from what one would consider to be a typical Metallica opening track, because it takes a couple of sharp turns later on in the song and becomes almost like a full circle type of thing. It just sort of goes from one extreme to another, then back again. Lyrically, this one's about the good old Mother Earth and how she's not doing too well nowadays. It's just about all the shit that's going on in the world right now, and how the whole environment that we're living in is slowly deteriorating into a shithole. This is not meant to be a huge environment statement or anything like that. It's just a harsh look at what's going on around us. I find it a little ironic in that quote that Lars talks about not wanting to do an over-the-top hour-long introduction. And I get what he means to a certain extent, where Fight Fire with Fire off Ride the Lightning and Battery off Master Puppets had the acoustic guitar introductions and then had this dramatic build till the riff sort of exploded into a more typical thrash metal song. And in that regard, Blackened is a lot different, but it has a lengthy intro nonetheless. The eerie, kind of strange sounding guitar part at the beginning, is the reason it sounds a little eerie and strange is because it's actually a reverse riff, meaning it's being played backwards. Now, after the backwards intro, Blackened does blast into what, at this point, is a pretty typical thrash metal opener for a Metallica album. But what is irregular about this opening riff is the time signature. Now, for those of you who've been listening to Metallicast, I talked about time signature or meter. You might hear me use both words. They both mean the same thing. But I talked about it during my Master of Puppets track-by-track breakdown. And I explained that music is sound structured in time. Without the structure, music is just noise. That's what separates music from noise. If I went out on a street and recorded the sounds of the cars whizzing by, that is noise. But if I took that noise and I looped it over and over again and created a timed structure to it, I've now created music. Might not be traditional music, might not be good music that we want to listen to, but it's music nonetheless. Music is any sound structured in time. So, time signatures or meter are very important. And the most commonly used time signature in music is 4/4. It is used so frequently that it is called common time as well. Now, if something is in 4/4, it sounds like this. The main riff to Enter Sandman is a perfect example of 4/4. You can hear Lars playing the snare on beats 2 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Listen as I count along with the song. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now the main riff in Blackened is in the irregular time signature of 7/4. And then it transitions into the verse riff, which is in another irregular time signature, 6/4. Listen as I count along to both riffs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. One, two, three, four, five, six. 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 I really love the lyrics on the Injustice for All album, and Blackened is no exception. In my opinion, Blackened is your typical apocalyptic lyrics that you would expect from a metal band, especially one like Metallica that at the time was one of the heaviest, fastest, darkest, most extreme metal bands out there. But the difference between James Hetfield and other metal lyricists, in my opinion, are that these lyrics, no matter how apocalyptic or violent or dark they get, they're done with a poeticism that you do not see from a lot of other bands, especially other thrash bands. Now, listen to how poetic these lyrics are. Blackened is the end. Winter it will send. Throwing all you see into obscurity. Death of Mother Earth. Never a rebirth. Evolution's end. Never will it mend. Never. Fire. To begin whipping dance of the dead. Blackened is the end. To begin whipping dance of the dead. Color our world blackened. I just need some bongos and a coffee shop and go out there on stage and recite James Hetfield's lyrics, I think. But in my opinion, with James Hetfield's lyrics, in this song, Blackened is no exception, there is an obvious message, but it's not overly obvious. You have to sort of look at the lyrics and read into it and they can be interpreted in different ways. And I think that is the sign of a great lyricist. And the part of the song that really stood out to me lyrically was the bridge.
See your mother put to death. See your mother die.
Those three lines right there, see your mother put to death, see your mother die. I have always loved that line. It just creates this visual when he spins it like, this is our mother. You have this visual of your own mother dying, and it makes you relate, in my opinion anyways, it makes you relate to the struggle and the torment that we're putting Mother Earth through, which is the overall message of this particular song.
See your mother put to death. See your mother die.
I definitely remember the first time I heard the song Blackened. Now, keep in mind, for those of you who might be new to the podcast, I am 33 years old, so I was one when Master of Puppets came out in 1986. So I did not discover the first four albums until I was in middle school, which was the Load, Reload, Garage Inc. era for Metallica. Now, I believe I was in sixth grade. I was home alone on New Year's Eve. I am the youngest of three. My two older brothers were out with friends because, like I said, they are older. And my parents were at a friend's house. So I was left home alone on New Year's Eve. And I remember to celebrate the new year, a local radio station, I believe it was WAAF, 107.3 FM in Boston, Massachusetts, was doing a Metallica A to Z. They're playing every single Metallica song that they had ever recorded up to that point in alphabetical order. And seeing how I did not yet have Ride the Lightning, Master of Puppets, or Injustice for All, I was listening to the radio for those particular songs, and I was queuing up my cassette, and I was recording those songs off the radio. The first one that I remember hearing from any of those albums is Blackened. And I remember listening in the car on my Walkman to this radio recorded version of Blackened in the dead of winter in New England. So whenever I hear this song, I have this vivid flashback to being in sixth, maybe I was in seventh grade, I think sixth though, and just feeling that New England brutal cold winter. And this is the perfect song and the perfect album that really matches it, because it's just such a bleak song and such a bleak sounding album. And that concludes the first part of In Summer for All, my breakdown of the song Blackened. Talked a little bit about the time changes, some of the irregular time signatures, some of my favorite lyrics, try to throw in some personal anecdotes in there. So I'm trying to make these episodes not too short, not too long. You know, we'll see how it goes if I get some guest hosts on board. Like I said, Metallicast Militia, please help me out. Contribute in any way you feel comfortable. If you want to contribute, you can message me on social media. I am at Metallicast Pod on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You can email me, metallicast@fansnotexperts.com. Maybe you want to do nothing for the show, but you want to help me get a guest host. Message them on social media. Try to convince them to free up their schedules and join me for a song or two or three. But of course, if you just love my podcast brilliance and you do not want me to fix what is not broken, and you just want my harmonious voice and my podcast brilliance, I understand. No guest hosts or contributions will be needed. But in all seriousness, I hope that you enjoy this first part of In Summer for All. I hope you enjoy the parts to come. Next Friday, track two, the title track, In Justice for All. And like every episode of Metallicast, I want to try end these with a cover song. But I'm going to end it with a cover of the song that I am covering. So here is a cover of Blackened by the band Between the Buried and Me. A very progressive metal band, if you're not familiar with them. Which I gotta imagine In Justice for All was a big influence on them, because this is quite the progressive album. Till next time, ladies and gentlemen, metal up your ass. Yeah!
fans, not experts.